10 by 2 split jerk. We're gonna have to alternate our feet on every rep. When I'm doing the split jerk, I wanna make sure that my feet are firmly planted in the ground. This movement starts from my feet and I have to remember that. I wanna make sure that everything is nice and tight. When I dip into the movement, I wanna make sure that my torso is very upright. I don't want any of that forward inclination. That'll cause the bar to go ahead and get in front of me. So I wanna make sure that I'm really leaning back and get ready to fire my hips. When I get to my hips, I wanna make sure that I'm getting all the power that I have out of them. So I wanna make sure that I'm driving them all the way up, getting them fully open, fully extended, and I'm gonna squeeze my tushy at the end. And when I hit the bottom, I wanna make sure that I'm aggressive. I wanna make sure that I really hit this movement at the bottom and firmly stay there before I actually bring my feet back to parallel.
For me, I would have to really think, all right, that's the side that's gotta go first, instead of, you know, I've been split jerking since I was 14, so my right leg knows to go forward. It just automatic. When I know I'm about to jerk a heavy weight, that's what goes forward. So I had to mentally say the words, that side has to go. 155, 165, 175, 185, 195, 205, 215, and then I did 225 for three attempts. And on each attempt, I succeeded at the first and dropped it after in the middle of the second rep.
So being a coach, I know that if I was watching another athlete do this and I was trying to coach them through it, I would really watch that first rep. That first rep is really solid. I might consider them staying at that weight. If you're nearing the end and the athlete's starting to get really defeated, it might be best to drop them down 5 pounds just so that, you know, they end on a really good note. But it really depends on the athlete. I know that some of our athletes can handle it, and ending on one good split jerk and then failing that second one won't be a problem. But for some athletes it is. So taking it down, having them nail two solid ones, will have them come back the next time they do split jerks that much stronger. For the split jerk, I started at 135. I did 10 pound increases. I was having a real problem switching to my non-dominant leg. I got a little stuck at 185. I think that maybe I should have done a little smaller increases at the end, maybe 5 pounds total, but I still had fun with it.
Like, I knew we were under that on push jerk.
No shit, right?
I think it just meant that you were expecting your left leg to go, so you didn't finish the push jerk. You would have had that.